Tremendous college basketball game. We're really grateful and thankful to our fans. Awesome environment and atmosphere. Credit to USD. Thought Coach Lee did a great job having his team prepared, made great adjustments from last game. Their guys played really hard, made a ton of shots early especially, and put us in a tough spot, and we had to dig ourselves out of a hole. So proud of our guys for their resiliency. They've been in spots like that before. They're winners, they're competitors, none more than the two guys sitting next to me. We were fortunate to come out with the win, though, today.
Yeah, you know, I really, it hasn't really sunk in yet. You know, I'm still just kind of trying to relive the atmosphere of Frost Arena. You know, my teammates put so much trust into me, and I know that this wasn't necessarily my game. I sat out with foul trouble, and these guys stepped up every second when I was out. And I'm just super thankful to have guys like this who are so unselfish and who have really helped me get in the position I am today.
You'd probably be able to give a better answer to this question in a couple of days, but I'll ask you right now. 3,000 points. I mean, only 10 guys have ever done it. I mean, what does that mean to you?
It's crazy. Like I said, I know. It's just, it's weird. It's not really comprehending in my mind yet. I mean, but at the same time, like, I literally have to give all the credit to my coaching staff, my family, and my teammates who have been along with me for this ride, you know, the past 5 years, because it started when I first got here and was a freshman. And, you know, TK is one of those guys who has ridden with me the whole way. And he was one of the, you know, the first guys that I really got close with here at SDSU. So, I mean, huge shout out to everyone who has been a part of this. You know, it hasn't just been me. It's been everyone who's helped me along the way.
Tevin, do you feel like it's sort of appropriate that Mike reached that milestone and it happened to be the game-winning shot, too?
I mean, it's always appropriate for Mike to have an amount of respect coming into all this. But 3K is amazing. I mean, I don't see it as a game winner or something like that. I just see it as him getting a regular bucket. I mean, that's what he always been doing. That's what I look for him to do.
How'd you guys come back? I mean, it almost got away from you in the first half.
You just got to stick to it. I mean, it's getting to that time where you want the momentum to come and be on your part of things. I mean, those guys, credit to them. They shot the ball well. They was prepared. I mean, you just got to have the guts. Go down the line. Be ready to do whatever it takes to win the game. Next play, next play, next play. I mean, that's how you get past everything, because it was a tough atmosphere for us. Even though we was at our home place, those guys played pretty well. But, I mean, credit to my teammates. Those guys stayed locked in every second of the way, and they made the right play.
What changes or adjustments did you make defensively? Because obviously the first half they couldn't miss, and you guys did a lot better on them in the second.
I mean, really just keeping them off the three-pointer, and that's what they was feeling tonight. Tonight, that's what they wanted to do and drive us. Just staying in front of your guy and everybody else being ready to help.
Mike, when you guys got, I don't remember who scored the basket first, but right before halftime you're down 16 and you got a basket, and then Skyler made the three at the buzzer.
Yep.
So instead of going in down 16, you're down 11. How big were those 5 points right before the break?
Huge, huge momentum swing for us. I mean, you know, we always go into the locker room and, we're hard on ourselves. We want to be better. We want to have quicker starts, but our guys' resiliency to just kind of stick with it no matter what was going on. And then, you know, right out of halftime, TK gets a big steal and scores, and that's another huge momentum shift. I thought our guys just did a great job of understanding the situations of the game, staying calm no matter what was going on. You know, they were hitting shots. You know, it was kind of going back and forth for a while. But our guys just did a great job of kind of locking in on the defensive end and, getting stops when we needed to.
Mike, it was a crazy finish those last couple minutes, but could you have any idea in the course of it before they announced it at the timeout? Did you have any idea that specific basket was the one for you?
I did. I mean, I'm not gonna lie. I look up at the score. I look up at the scoreboard, and I see what I have. You know, I was lost in the moment though. You know, we needed to score. We got a big stop on defense, and then our guys just stepped up and made the plays when we needed to at the end.
With the tournament basically upon us, I mean, you guys got one more game next week. The last four games have been a little close. I mean, are you guys a little afraid that you're slipping, or is the mentality just kind of not been there recently?
Not at all. For us, you know, we're moving forward every day. And I think that us getting these types of games possibly out of the way for us is going to help us, you know, make that jump over the hump and really put together a 40-minute game for us. You know, and at the same time, it's good for us to see close games like this. It's good for us to see what it takes to get over that, you know, kind of hump in the game where, you know, well, we need to get a stop here, we need to score, and our guys are stepping up in big moments, big pivotal moments, and, you know, the guys stepping up like Alex, TK, huge night tonight, David, just willingness to make the winning play, Sky hitting big shots, Matt Dentlinger coming in, Owen King coming in and hitting big free throws at the end. I think our guys are just seeing what it takes at the end of the game to win it.
Can I give you the same question that I asked those guys?
Yeah, I think I'll tell you this. A couple things are going on. One, our league's a lot better and gotten a lot better through the course of the year than people think it has been. I think a lot of teams are trying to search for themselves in November and December. And whether you look at USD, NDSU, Omaha, or Fort Wayne, those are not the same teams that those teams were in November and December. They're all playing at a really high level. They all had to compensate for losing key players, and they're all playing great, number one. Number two is, truth of the matter is, we're getting people's best shot. They want to beat us, and they want to beat us bad. So they're very prepared. That team, I mean, USD today, they were extremely prepared. I mean, they were stubborn. They had a great plan. They executed. They made shots. They did everything. So I feel like with our guys, I mean, I know that we've been a pretty successful team. We got a couple elite scores. So the expectation is that we're going to win every game by 25. In our locker room, we hope that we can play our best. And I know – shoot, that's still in front of us. We have not played 40 minutes of exceptional basketball with our group yet this year. I thought we had a game early in the year at Nevada. We played well for a while, and that was what Mike and David both having, 5 points. So our best is still in front of us. We're going to get there.
What was going wrong defensively in the first half?
Everything. You know, one, obviously we started in 2-3 zone. It was effective for us in Vermilion. I think it's given them trouble against Oral Roberts. I think they've struggled with it a little bit, and I think against Southern Miss as well. So we said, you know what, it worked in Vermilion. Let's give it a whirl. Credit to Coach Lee. Had them really prepared to knock down shots, and they made the plays. As the game went on, we adjusted. We had to adjust multiple times defensively. I think both teams are going back and forth, adjusting personnel and who's guarding who and what are we trying to do. And so it was really, I felt like, a battle that way too. So, you know, just fortunate in the end, our guys' energy, the energy of our fans propelled us to victory.
How big did you think the 5 points were there right before the end of the half?
Huge. I mean, it was absolutely. And the momentum, too, I mean, going in, when you're down 16, but the crowd was going nuts. We're down 55-44. Our guys are walking off the court like we just played a masterpiece, you know. And credit to Sky, goodness. I mean, TK made a heck of a pass. He threw that thing on a rope right into his shot pocket. But they were draped all over Skyler. I mean, he hit the two big threes at the end of the Fort Wayne game and then goes 4-for-5 today when they were really staying close to him. But that was a huge energy play. And then just, you know, again, those, we needed every one of those plays because Tevin Steele to start the half and then DJ getting fouled on the three-point shot. We needed all those points just to manufacture and get right back in the game.
Did they do a good job, it seemed like, of just keeping the ball away from Mike? There was that stretch in the second half when he was a basket away from 3,000, ironically enough, that he just couldn't get the ball.
Yeah, we, you know, they did a great job. I mean, quite frankly, they were guarding Mike most of the night with three guys. I mean, it sounds like, you know, or it looks like to everybody else, well, he's taller, just throw it up to him. But they've got multiple guys. They have that whole thing schemed where we were a little bit stagnant, I think, offensively because we were trying so hard to throw Mike the ball early, and that was putting other guys on their heels, and that took us out of our rhythm, to be honest. And so in the second half, really what we did is we put it in TK's hands, tried to space the floor around our shooters, let him play one-on-one in the middle of the floor. And he converted time and time again and made plays. And then Owen King made plays and Alex made plays. And how they devised their defensive plan, they basically said late in the game, we're going to try everything we can to prevent Mike and Jenkins from getting the ball. And they did a great job doing that. Our other guys that don't normally have the ball in those spots stepped up.
Did you have anything in mind or envisioning for Mike getting to 3,000 points tonight?
You know, it's crazy because I really didn't. You just take for granted how easy or with it, – it's almost like he scores 25 without breaking a sweat. I mean, he's apologizing to me after the game how he played tonight. Like, I just didn't bring it. I didn't play great. And so it's amazing how he does it. Again, I have to do a better job of living in the moment with him in each one of these because to score 3,000 on the bucket that he did, it's a pretty good story. I mean – game's on the line. You go to your go-to guy. It hadn't really been his night the way that he normally gets it going, and then he scores it that way. But I mean, that's kind of how the Mike Daum story's been. It's been a little bit of a fairy tale, and he steps up when he needs to. And so it's pretty cool that it happened the way it did, and awesome that it was able to happen in Frost, and even better that it was the go-ahead bucket that really helped us win the game.
3,000 points is hard to fathom, though, isn't it, at the end of the day?
It is hard to fathom because it speaks to a lot of things. I mean, it's one, his continued development. It's two, it's longevity, its ability to stay healthy, its ability to continue to score it in a lot of ways when other teams are keying their whole defense a lot of nights into stopping you. I mean, it's not like he's playing one-on-one out there any night. I mean, it's two to three defenders. So it's even more remarkable when you think about all that. And then fortunate to be in a program where other guys want him to score and they want to get him the ball. There's nobody out there that's freezing him out or not trying to get it to him when he can. So a lot of things have to go right to score 3,000 points. And first and foremost, a credit to Mike, but I'm really proud of our other guys because they look to him, they get it to him, they know he's our guy. And at this day and age, young people come up playing basketball a lot of times like it's an individual sport. I'm fortunate to coach guys that want to get the guy the ball at the right time. And we're pretty lucky all the way around. But like I said, Mike's phenomenal. He's been phenomenal over a huge stretch. So